Hello, and welcome to the March edition of Sparrow News. Today we'll celebrate our nurses and doctors, learn about a major new honor for the Sparrow Stroke Center, and so much more. So stay tuned. The Sparrow Stroke Center, in collaboration with Michigan State University, has achieved recognition as the first facility in Michigan and one of only 19 nationally to be certified as a comprehensive stroke center by the Joint Commission.
It means a lot for the caregivers here, but mainly for the community within mid-Michigan. Heaven forbid, if somebody were to have a stroke, they should feel confident that the level of care that they will be provided with here locally will be excellent.
And the prompt attention I got minimized the deficits that I currently still have. So neurologically, visual spatial problems, stuff like that, the impact on my brain was, I think, greatly reduced based on the fact that they were quick and attentive to all my needs.
This is one of numerous awards the Sparrow Stroke Center has earned for excellent service over the last decade. Patient safety is a top priority at Sparrow, and through a new campaign, caregivers are reminded that they can speak up about safety issues. Larry Wilhite, Vice President for Legal and Risk Services, tells us more.
It's about three things: teamwork, communication, and patient safety. So we're asking our caregivers to speak up. If they see an unsafe act, they're free to report it, and they are free to stop it. Stop the line right there and protect the patient.
Sparrow is committed to being recognized as a national leader in quality and patient experience. To achieve that goal, we must all work together to maintain a safe environment for both patients and caregivers. At Sparrow, we are constantly inspired by the people in the community we serve, like TCI caregiver Diana Lavradier of Charlotte, who overcame obesity, breast cancer, and other health issues. After Diana contacted Sparrow leaders with her story, she was offered a membership at the MAC in order to train for the 2013 National Senior Olympics in biking. She now inspires others to adopt a healthier lifestyle.
I weighed 270 pounds, and I think I was like a size 24, so I was pretty large, and started exercising and started eating healthier and lost approximately 130 pounds. And by the end of it all, I had reversed all the health issues and was taken off all medication for those. And I've been breast cancer free for 8 years now. Before I turned 50, I was exercising and losing weight. And I'm like, okay, I was just kind of joking to people, you know, what can I do to celebrate turning 50? And I kind of got interested and found out about Senior Olympics, and I was able to qualify. So now I'm training this year to go to the National Games in Cleveland, Ohio to do that race. I'm probably the healthiest I've been in a long, long time.
We would like to wish Diana good luck when she competes in the National Senior Olympics in July. Here at Sparrow, it's everyone's job to keep our patients safe by following established procedures and by being accountable at all levels. Marianne Ball, Director of Accreditation, fills us in on details about an upcoming on-site accreditation survey by the Joint Commission.
There are a number of ways that we've been preparing for it. One of the things that we do is communicate. That's the most important thing. Expectations of what the Joint Commission has of any healthcare organization. We also try to get frontline staff engaged in knowing what is expected of them. That's the hardest part, knowing what's expected.
Sparrow has embarked on an aggressive campaign to ensure all caregivers have the information they need to prepare for the survey. See your manager or department leader for more information. When not caring for Sparrow patients, pharmacist Keith Coker is an award-winning stage hypnotist and magician. He will be featured in the Caregiver Variety Show at the Hanna Community Center March 23rd at 7 p.m., along with numerous other talented Sparrow caregivers.
Do your coworkers know about your special powers?
To be honest with you, my performance side is totally separate from the hospital side. And although I think a lot of my coworkers know, I really don't play that up much at work. I really focus on this part of the work, being very serious.
And how often do you have shows?
I think probably I'm doing between 150 to 200 shows a year, traveling throughout the Midwest.
Am I hypnotized right now?
You could be.
Funds raised by the event benefit the Care for the Caregivers Fund, which provides assistance to caregivers who have experienced a major loss, catastrophe, illness, or medical condition affecting their well-being. Now, let's take a look at some upcoming events around Sparrow. Recently, during the annual Sparrow State of Nursing event, nurses were honored for their work throughout the year, including the Preceptor of the Year and Nursing Quality Awards. The event is a special way to recognize the vital role nurses play in providing quality, compassionate patient care. It's also the time of year that we recognize the contributions of physicians to individual lives and communities. National Doctors' Day is celebrated on March 30th, where we show appreciation for our physicians, whose commitment and tireless dedication is one reason Sparrow was selected to join the Mayo Clinic Care Network and was honored with the Michigan Quality Council's Leadership Award.
If caregivers have a particular physician in mind that they'd like to thank, they can go on the website and tell them thank you and mention the kind of impact that they've had both in the hospital and then for their patients. We don't do this because for the accolades. We don't do this for the money. It's we do this for our patients. And when somebody just reaches out and tells us that, yeah, that was you really went above and beyond, that's very, very meaningful.
The messages will be used to celebrate Doctors' Day and thank Sparrow physicians during an afternoon reception on Monday, March 25th. Well, that wraps up the March edition of Sparrow News. Thanks for watching, and be sure to join us next month when we bring you more news from Sparrow.